What is a basis of calculation? It's the mass or moles, whether it's an amount or it's a flow rate to which the rest of your calculations are related. You can choose whatever basis you want, but it's usually clear when an appropriate basis should be. So let's look at some examples. So we're gonna have 100 moles per minute of an equal molar mixture of water and acetone. And it enters a separator, which separates the mixture into two separate streams. So the first one we'll call N1, and that's 65 mole percent acetone, and therefore 35 mole percent water. The second stream, N2, is 75% water, so that makes it 25%, and again, these are all mole percent acetone. And these are known respectively as the acetone-rich and the water-rich streams. And what we want to do is find the flow rate of the acetone-rich stream. Here it's clear our basis should be what we're given, 100 moles per minute. And from that, we can calculate that this N1 is equal to 62.5 moles per minute. What happens, though, if you have the exact same problem, but coming in right here, you have 4.3 times 10 to the 6th moles per hour. Now, you could certainly use that as your basis, but it might be a little bit easier if instead you used 43 moles per hour coming in and then scaling them all up. So if you use 43, your N1 is going to be equal to 27 moles per hour. But you take this and you scale them all up by multiplying every flow rate by 1 times 10 to the 5th, and that'll give you the answer based on this original 4.3 times 10 to the 6th. Now let's look at a problem where we're not given any flow rates at all. We're not given our 100 or we're not given our 43 moles per hour. Here you have to assume a basis to solve for the rest of the variables. However, you have to be very careful here because if you assume a basis of 100 moles, let's say per second, you're going to get different answers than if you assume, for example, 43 moles per second. Therefore, in order to assume a basis is when you are solving, for example, for a ratio. So let's say here what we're looking for, so this is going to be our NN, and what we want is the ratio of the acetone-rich stream to the water-rich stream. Because this is a ratio, we can assume a basis, and let's start by assuming a basis of 100 moles per minute again. And so when we calculate this, we get what we got before. So this is equal to 62.5 moles per minute, and our N2 is equal to 37.5 moles per minute, and the ratio is going to be 1.7. What if instead we changed this to, and we'll make it easy on ourselves, 50 moles per minute. Now the flow rates themselves are going to change. As you can imagine, our new N1 and our new N2 are going to be half of what they were when it was 100 moles per minute, but this ratio is still going to stay the same. What if we assume that the acetone-rich stream coming out is 50 moles per minute? We'll therefore have to solve for the stream coming in and the stream coming out. And when you solve the material balance, you find that N2 is equal to 30 moles per minute, and this ratio still is 1.7. So another time you can assume a basis is when you're finding a composition. So we're going to use a slightly different example where we're going to use three components instead of two. So let's say that coming in, we have a stream that is 50 molar percent water, 40 molar percent solvent, and 10 molar percent acetone. And coming out, the water-rich stream is going to be, and we'll call this N1 again, and so this is going to be 60% water and the rest acetone and solvent. And finally, the solvent-rich stream exiting the separator, so this is N2, and this is going to be 60% solvent, 30% water, and the rest is going to be acetone. So here we're looking for the composition of the acetone-rich stream. And so what that means is the mole fractions or the mole percents. So because it's a composition, we can assume a basis, and we're going to assume a basis of 100 moles per minute coming in. So here we're going to have to use three equations. So let's take a look at what those equations are going to look like. So we're going to do an overall balance that says N1 plus N2 is equal to 100. Then we're going to do a water balance that says 0.6 N1 plus 0.3 N2 is going to be equal to 0.5 times 100, or 50. So our third balance that we're going to use is acetone. And here we know that the number of moles of acetone coming in is 10, and that's going to be equal to the mole fraction of acetone times its flow rate plus the 0.1 times N2. And so when we solve for these equations, we come up with that N1 is equal to 66.7 moles per minute, and N2 is equal to 33.3 moles per minute. And then solving finally this equation for the mole fraction of acetone, that's going to be equal to 0.098. If instead we use a basis of 50 moles per minute, these numbers will change. So it'll be exactly half. So this will be 50, this will be 25, and this will be 5. And when we solve for these, we're going to find that they're going to be half of what they were. So this is approximately 33.3 moles per minute, and this is going to be about 16.6, and these are both in moles per minute. And when we solve for Y sub A, we still get 0.098. So to summarize how to use a basis, if you're given an easy flow rate, go ahead and use it. If instead you're given a difficult flow rate, then what you can do is change it into something easier and then scale up, or even down. And finally, you can assume a basis, but this is only if you're looking for some kind of ratio or some kind of composition.